Welcome. Today's lecture is on consistency of system of linear equations. Subject code is MA151 and subject name is Mathematics 1. Before starting this lecture, we will discuss about the topics studied in the previous lectures. So in the first lecture, I introduced matrices. In the second lecture, I reviewed some of the properties and operations of matrices. In the third lecture, I discussed elementary row operations and how to obtain inverse of a given matrix by applying elementary row operations. That method is known as Gauss-Jordan method of finding inverse of a matrix. In the fourth lecture, I discussed rank of a matrix and defined the concept of rank, and we also calculated rank of some of the matrices by applying the definition of the rank only, which requires evaluation of determinants. Then we also discussed examples in which we calculated rank of the given matrix by applying elementary row operations. So after applying elementary row operations, we converted the given matrix into an upper triangular form and then in echelon form, and then we calculated the rank of the matrix by finding the number of non-zero rows in that matrix. So we have studied all these concepts. Next, we will discuss the systems of linear equations and how to solve the system of linear equations and how to decide the consistency of a given system of linear equation. By the consistency of a system of linear equation, we mean that whether the system of linear equation will have a solution or not. If the system of linear equation has a solution, then we will say that the system is consistent. And if there is no solution, then we will say that the system is inconsistent. So this is the meaning of consistency of a system of linear equation. Next, I give you a system of linear equations in n number of variables and m equations. So look at this set of linear equations. The equations are linear because the variables x1, x2, x3, xn all have power 1 only. So there is no square of the variables x1, x2, xn. And further, we have b1, b2, bm on the right hand side. So here you can note down m. So the number of equations is m. To visualize the set of linear equations, I can consider a system of linear equation with 3 variables only also. So a system having 3 equations and 3 variables will look like this. A21x1 plus A22x2 plus A33 A2 3x3 equal to b2, a31x1 plus a32x2 plus a33x3 equal to b3. So here we have 2, 3. So it is a system of linear equation having 3 variables only, x1, x2, x3, and 3 equations. Now we will understand how to calculate the how to find the solution of this system and how to decide whether this system is consistent or not by applying the idea of calculating rank by elementary row operations. Before that, I will show you how to convert. We can write this set of linear equations in the form of one matrix equation only. So I can represent all the linear equations by one matrix equation. How? By our knowledge of matrix multiplication, we can write these three equations in this form of one matrix equation. So if I write all the coefficients in the form of a matrix, so I will have this 3 by 3 coefficient matrix of this system. So A21, A22, A23, then A31, A32, A33. So this is our coefficient matrix for this system of linear equations. Next, I have a vector. This vector contains three elements, x1, x2, x3. Another vector also having three elements this time, b1, b2, b3. So we know how to multiply matrices. So if you will multiply this 3 by 3 matrix with this 3 by 1 column matrix, then we will have a column matrix having three elements only, and you will find that those three elements are left hand sides of all these three equations. And then by the equality of matrices, we will get these three equations from this one matrix equation. In the next slide, I will illustrate the same idea for a system of m linear equations in n unknowns. So this matrix equation will look like this. Now if I denote this coefficient matrix by A and that column vector containing variables x1, x2, x3, xn by capital X, and the right hand side column vector containing b1, b2, b3, bm by capital D, then I can write this set of linear equations in this form, in this one matrix equation, Ax equal to D, where A is this coefficient matrix, X is this variable vector, and D is that right hand side column vector. For this example also, we can have Ax equal to D type equation, matrix equation, to represent all the three equations. So A will denote this coefficient matrix, X will denote this column vector, variable vector, and D will denote this right hand side column vector. All these things are represented also in this slide. So this is our coefficient matrix, this is our variable vector, and D is our right hand side column vector. So we will use this terminology to solve the system and to understand the consistency of the given system of linear equation with the help of rank, with the help of calculating rank. So we will need this terminology. Next, I have discussed this terminology. Now we have two terms to study the consistency of the system of linear equation. We will classify the system in two categories. The first category is homogeneous linear equations, the second category is non-homogeneous linear equations. So If the right hand side column vector, if the right hand side column vector is a zero vector, means if all the entries of the right hand side column vector are zero, then the matrix equation will become Ax equal to zero. And this type of system of linear equation is known as a system of homogeneous linear equations. When right hand side column vector is a zero vector, when all the entries of the right hand side column vector are zero. Next, if the right hand side column vector is a non-zero vector, means if at least one of the b1, b2, bm is non-zero, then the system is said to be a system of non-homogeneous linear equation. So whenever any one of the right hand side column vector entries b1, b2, bm will be non-zero, then we will say that our system is a non-homogeneous system of linear equation. In today's lecture, we will study how to discuss consistency of non-homogeneous linear equations and how to solve non-homogeneous system of linear equations. In the next lecture, we will also discuss the homogeneous linear equation systems. Further, to solve a system of linear equation by applying the idea of rank, we will require the concept of augmented matrix. So we will need the concept of augmented matrix. So this augmented matrix, we will denote this augmented matrix by C, and it is calculated by writing the coefficient matrix A and the right hand side column vector D side by side. So if I will write coefficient matrix and the right hand side column vector side by side, then such a matrix will be known as augmented matrix. So calculating augmented matrix will help us in finding the solution of the system as well as in deciding the consistency of the given system. So augmented matrix for this system of linear equation having three variables and three equations will look like this. So the augmented matrix for this system will be A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. And next, I will write the right hand side column vector B1, B2, B3. So this matrix C will be the augmented matrix of this given system. So we will need this to find the solution and to discuss consistency of the given system. Now in this slide you can see the augmented matrix for a system having n equations in n variables. So the same concept, I have written coefficient matrix and the right hand side column vector side by side. So this gives me the augmented matrix. After calculating the augmented matrix of the given system, we will find the rank of the augmented matrix. So to solve a non-homogeneous system of linear equations in which right hand side column vector should be non-zero, we will calculate the rank of the augmented matrix. After calculating the rank, augmented matrix, if we find that the rank of the augmented matrix is equal to rank of the coefficient matrix and the common number is equal to small n, common number is equal to small n, which is the number of variables of the given system. In that case, the system will be consistent and will have a unique solution. The system will be consistent, will have a solution, and will have a unique solution. Means, will have one and only one solution. Further, when we will calculate the rank of the augmented matrix, then the rank of the coefficient matrix will be decided simultaneously. So, we will not calculate the rank of the coefficient matrix separately. So the rank of the coefficient matrix will come automatically when we will try to find the rank of the augmented matrix. So this is the first situation. If the rank of augmented matrix is equal to rank of coefficient matrix and it is equal, this common number is equal to the number of unknowns, which is n in our case, then the system will be consistent and will have a unique solution. Second case, if the rank of the augmented matrix is equal to coefficient matrix, but this common number is less than the number of variables, which is n, if this common number is less than the number of variables, then the system will be consistent, because the rank of augmented matrix is the rank of coefficient matrix. So the system will be consistent. But this common number is less than or equal to the number of variables, therefore this time we will have infinite number of solutions. So you can note down, I am not writing that the solution will be infinite. I am writing that we will have infinite number of solutions. So it should be very clear. We will see these concepts with the help of examples also. Third case, in which supposing the rank of the augmented matrix is not equal to the rank of the coefficient matrix, then the system will have no solution. So the system will be inconsistent. Whenever the rank of the augmented matrix is not equal to the rank of the coefficient matrix, then the system will be inconsistent and will have no solution. So with the help of these three cases, we will be able to decide the consistency of a given system of linear equations after finding the rank of the augmented matrix. Now, after checking above three conditions, if we find that the system is consistent, then we can find the solution also by the method of rank. To find the solution, what we will do, we will convert the upper triangular or echelon form of the augmented matrix. Because we would have calculated the rank of the augmented matrix up to this point, so we would have find the upper triangular form and then the echelon form. So we will convert that upper triangular form and our echelon form into the linear equations once again. So if we will convert echelon form into linear equations, then you will find that it will be very easy to solve that system of linear equation by applying back substitution only, and we will be able to solve this set of linear equations very easy. Further, the solution of the given matrix and the solution of the system of equations obtained from the echelon form will be same, will be equal, because we will be applying raw operations only. So both the matrices, the given matrix and its echelon form, will be equivalent matrices. So we'll have equal solution. So we start an example in which the given matrix is, the given system of linear equation is x minus 2y plus 3z equal to a, and the second equation is 2x minus 3y equal to minus 5, and third equation is x plus y plus z equal to 9. We denote this system by symbol star, and we want to discuss consistency, and we also want to solve this system of linear equation. So as discussed earlier, what we will do, we will first convert the given system into matrix equation. First we will convert the given system into matrix equation, and then we will try to calculate the augmented matrix. And after calculating augmented matrix, we will find the rank of the augmented matrix. After calculating rank of the augmented matrix, we will compare the rank of the augmented matrix and the rank of the coefficient matrix. And then we will discuss the consistency. So our first step will be to write the given system as a matrix equation. So we can observe that the coefficient matrix will be 1, minus 2, 3 and 2, minus 3, 0, 1, 1, 1. So it will be the coefficient matrix. Variable vector will be x, y, z, and the right hand side column vector will have entries 8, minus 5 and 9. So in this way we will be able to write the given system of linear equation in the form of a matrix equation, where A is this coefficient matrix, X is this variable vector, and D is the right hand side column vector. Next, we write the augmented matrix. So the augmented matrix will be this matrix 1 minus 2, 3, 8, 2 minus 3, 0, minus 5, 1, 1, 1, 9. So to calculate the augmented matrix, what I have done, I have written coefficient matrix and the right hand side column vector D side by side. So this is our augmented matrix. Now I wrote down this augmented matrix, and next we will try to calculate the rank of this augmented matrix by applying elementary law operations. So to find rank of this augmented matrix, we need to convert this matrix into upper triangular form and then in SLM form. So to do so, we need to apply raw operations to create 0 on these two positions, to create 0 at 2 and 0 at 1. So we will apply R2 minus 2R1 operation. So we will replace second raw by R2 minus 2R1, and we will apply R3 minus R1 operation. This means we will replace R3 raw by R3 minus R1. So these are the operations which we will apply to convert the given matrix into an upper triangular form. So in this way we will find that we have created 0 below the 1, 1 position, the principal diagonal position 1, 1. Next, we need to create 0 below the 2-1 position, 2-2 position, which is this one. To create 0 below this 2-2 position, we need to apply R3 minus 3R2 operation. So we apply that operation, R3 minus 3R2, After applying this operation, we will have a 0 at this place and remaining entries will change accordingly. So we will get this upper triangular form. Now we check whether it is in SLM form or not. For that, what we do, we check whether there are any two row which are constant multiple of each other or which are equal. So we find that there are no two rows which are constant multiple of each other or equal. So we say that the given matrix is in SLM form. Now we decide the rank of the augmented matrix and the coefficient matrix. So the rank of the augmented matrix will be equal to the number of non-zero row. So rank of augmented matrix will be equal to 3. And the rank of the coefficient matrix can be calculated by ignoring this last column. So the rank of the coefficient matrix will also be 3. So we find that the rank of the augmented matrix and the rank of the coefficient matrix both are 3, and the number of variables in this case, as you can see in the given system of linear equation, the number of variables is also 3. So the system is consistent because the rank of the coefficient matrix and rank of the augmented matrix is equal, and this common number is equal to number of unknowns. Therefore, the system will have a unique solution. We'll have one and only one solution. Now, next, to find that solution, what we will do? The given system of equation was this. I denoted that system by star, and this is the SLM form of the augmented matrix. I am denoting it by double star. Both the system will represent, both the system will have same solution. So the system of equations which I will obtain from this SLM form will look like this. So if I convert the SLM form again into linear equations, then I will get x minus 2y plus 3z equal to 8 and y minus 6z equal to minus 21 and 16z equal to 64. So the solution of this system of linear equation and the solution of the given system of linear equation will be same, because we have obtained this SLM form by applying raw operations only on the augmented matrix of the given system. So both the system will have same solution. So we find solution of this system of linear equations which we have obtained from the SLM form, and you will find that we can easily calculate the solution. So the last equation gives us z equal to 4, and if you will substitute z equal to 4 here, then you will find that y is equal to 3, and if you will substitute y equal to 3 and z equal to 4 in the first equation, then you will be able to find the value of x as 2. All these calculations are also given here in this slide. So these are the converted equations. Next, we calculate the solution. So our solution is x equal to 2, y equal to 3 and z equal to 4. So this was the example of consistent system of linear equation with unique solution. Next, we look at one more example in which we will see other cases also. So this is the system. definition of linear equation, to discuss its consistency and to solve this system, we will convert it into matrix equation and then we will find the augmented matrix. So this A matrix is the coefficient matrix of the given system, calculated by writing the coefficients of the variables x, y, z in the form of a 3 by 3 matrix, because we have 3 equations and 3 variables. So this is coefficient matrix, this is variable vector, and this is right hand side column vector. Next we calculate the augmented matrix. So augmented matrix of that system will be 2, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, minus 1, 2, and 5, 4, 3, 4. We note down this augmented matrix here also on the board for reference. Now we want to calculate rank of this augmented matrix. To calculate the rank of this augmented matrix, what we can do here is that we can exchange first and second row, so that we will have one on the 1-1 position, and after that we will be able to apply simple row operations. So we interchange first and second row, and after this we will apply operations from the point of view to have 0 at this position and to have 0 at this position where we have 2 and 5. So we will apply row operation R2 replaced by R2 minus 2R1 and R3 replaced by R3 minus 5R1. So these are the two row operations which we want to apply. After applying these two row operations, we will have 0 below the 1-1 position. So we will have 0 at all the positions below the 1-1 position. Next we concentrate on the 2-2 position. So our next aim will be to create 0 below the 2-2 position. So that we can do by applying R3 minus 2R2 operation. So we apply that operation to have 0 below the 2-2 position. So after applying R3 minus 2R2 operation, we will have a 0 below the 2-2 position. Now here we observe that our matrix has converted into an upper triangular form, and this form is also an SLL form, because no two rows are constant multiple of each other or equal. So we have SLL form. Now if we calculate the rank of the augmented matrix, the rank of the augmented matrix is equal to the number of non-zero row. Here the number of non-zero row is 2. So the rank of the augmented matrix is 2. To find the rank of the coefficient matrix, we will ignore this last column. In that case also, we will find that the rank of the coefficient matrix is also 2. So the system will be consistent, because the rank of the augmented matrix is equal to rank of the coefficient matrix. But this time the system will not have a unique solution, because this common number 2 is less than the number of unknowns, which is 3 for our given system of linear equation. So the number of unknown is 3, whereas the rank of augmented matrix and rank of coefficient matrix are equal, but the common number is 2, which is less than the number of unknowns. So the system will be consistent but will not have a unique solution, will have infinite number of solutions. Now we will see how to calculate all those infinite number of solutions. So that will be very interesting. For that we will try to convert the SLM then you will get x plus 2y minus z equal to 2 and minus 3y plus 4z equal to minus 3. So we will have only two equations. Now we can solve these equations very easily because we have only two equations and there are three variables. So any one of the variable can take value equal to an arbitrary constant. So at least one of the variable must be an arbitrary constant because the number of given conditions are less than the number of variables. So you can select any of the variable as an arbitrary constant. You can select x equal to k, you can select y equal to k, you can select z equal to k, where k is an arbitrary constant. So what I do is I select z equal to k. Now if I select z equal to k, then I can calculate the value of y from second equation, and if I input the values of y and z in the first equation, then I will be able to calculate the value of x in terms of k, where k is arbitrary constant. So it can take value, any real value. If we have a restriction on the given variables, that our variables must be real, then this arbitrary constant will take any real value. So this is the converted system of linear equations from the Salon form. Next, if we select z equal to k, then you will be able to calculate the value of y equal to 1 plus 4 by 3k and the value of x equal to minus 5 by 3k, where k is arbitrary constant. So we can give any value to k. So we will, in this way, we will have infinite number of solutions. So k can have value 0. So if you will select k equal to 0, then x will be equal to 0, y will be equal to 1, and z will be equal to 0. So you will find that x equal to 0, y equal to 1, and z equal to 0 satisfies the given system of linear equation. Further, if we can take any value of k, for example, here we have selected k equal to 3. If we select k equal to 3, then x is equal to minus 5, y equal to 5, and z is equal to 3. So this is also a solution. This solution will also satisfy the given system of linear equations. So the given system of linear equation have infinite number of solutions in this way. And when we select a particular value of the given arbitrary constant, then we get a particular solution. And the solution of the system having arbitrary constant k is known as general solution of the system of linear equation. So x equal to minus 5 by 3k, y equal to 1 plus 4 by 3k, and z equal to k is a general solution of the given system of linear equations. Next, we take one more example to have idea about the third case, the case of inconsistency, no solution case. So for that we take this example. So we have this system of linear equation: x minus 4y plus 7z equal to 14, 3x plus 8y minus 2z equal to 13, 7x minus 8y plus 26z equal to 5. To solve this system, first we convert the given system into matrix equation. So we will have a coefficient matrix equal to 1 minus 4, 7, 3, 8 minus 2, 7 minus 8, 26. And the variable vector will be x, y, z. And the right hand side column vector will be 14, 13, and 5. And our Euclidean matrix will be this 3 by 4 matrix. After calculating the Euclidean matrix, our aim will be to find its rank. To find its rank, we will try to convert this matrix into upper triangular form. To convert it into upper triangular form, what we will do, we will concentrate first on 1-1 position and then we will try to create 0 below the 1-1 position. So for that, we will apply two row operations, R2 minus 3R1 and R3 minus 7R1 to have 0 at these two positions. So if I apply those two operations, two raw operations, then I will get this form of the augmented matrix. So next I considered on 2-2 position and I try to create 0 below the 2-2 position, and for that I can apply R3 minus R2 operation in this case. So I apply R3 minus R2 operation. So after applying this operation, our augmented matrix will look like this. Now here the rank of this matrix is in SLN form. Now the rank of the augmented matrix will be 3, because there are 3 non-zero rows in the augmented matrix, but the rank of the coefficient matrix will be 2, because the rank of the coefficient matrix will be found by ignoring this last column. So the rank of the coefficient matrix will be 2. So the rank of the augmented matrix is not equal to the rank of the coefficient matrix, therefore this system will have no solution and this system will be inconsistent. So in this case you will not be able to find any solution. We can apply the same method. We can apply this method to a system of linear equation having 4 equations and 3 variables also, having any number of equations and any number of variables. So why I am emphasizing on this fact? Because you must have studied 2 other methods to solve a system of linear equations, which are known as Cramer's rule, the method of determinants to solve the system of linear equation, and the method of matrix inverse. Both the methods are applicable only when the number of variables and number of equation is equal. If the number of equation and number of variables are equal, then those methods will be applicable. But we will find that this method is also applicable, this method of solving system of linear equation by the idea of rank is also applicable to the system having different number of rows and different number of variables. So we look at one such example. So we consider a system of linear equation whose coefficient matrix is given as 5, 3, 14, 0, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 6. So the coefficient matrix of the system is given, and the variable vector has 3 variables, x, y, z, and right hand side column vector contains 4 entries, 4, 1, 0, 2. So this given system of linear equations is equivalent to these 4 equations. So I can have those 4 equations also: 5x plus 3y plus 14z equal to 4 by matrix multiplication, and y plus 2z equal to 1, and x plus y plus 2z equal to 0, and 2x plus y plus 6z equal to 2. So So the Cramer's rule and matrix division method will fail to solve such a system of linear equations, whereas our rank method will successfully decide the consistency of this system and will also solve this system of linear equation. So we have a matrix form, so we can write the augmented matrix C immediately by writing coefficient matrix and the right hand side column vector side by side. So the coefficient matrix is this 4 by 3 matrix, and the right hand side column vector has 4 entries, which are 4, 1, 0, 2. So I have written coefficient matrix and the right hand side column vector side by side to have an augmented matrix. Now, to discuss consistency and to solve, we need to find the rank of this augmented matrix. To find rank of this augmented matrix, what we can do is that we need to convert it into upper triangular form. So for that, I can apply a raw interchange. So I interchange R1 and R3. So the augmented matrix will look like this after applying this operation. So why I am interchanging R1 and R3? Because to have one here, so that I can, after that I can decide simple raw operations. So that will reduce our computational efforts. So 1, 1, 2, 0 will be the first row. Second row will be 0, 1, 2, 1. As in third row, I select 2, 1, 6, 2. And fourth row is 5, 3, 14, 4. So you can observe that after applying R1 and R3, I have applied R3 interchange R4 also to have the larger element at the in the bottom row. Now to convert this matrix into upper triangular form, I concentrate on 1-1 position and I will try to create 0 below the 1-1 position. So at this second position, I already have a 0, so I will apply raw operations to create 0 at this 2 and 5. So I apply R3 minus 2R1 operation and R4 minus 5R1 operation to have 0 at these two positions. After applying these two operations, I will have an equivalent form of the augmented matrix in which the first row will be same 1, 1, 2, 0. Second row will be 0, 1, 2, 1, same. The third row and fourth row will change. So this third row will be replaced by R3 minus 2R1. So minus 2 plus 2, 0. Minus 2 plus 1 minus 1, minus 4 plus 6, 2, 0 and 2, 2. Now I calculate the third row. For third row, for fourth row, I need to apply R4 minus 5R1. So minus 5, 5, 0, minus 5 plus 3 minus 2, minus 10 plus 14, 4, 0, plus 4, 4. So I get this form of the augmented matrix. Now, next, I concentrate on 2-2 position. So I will try to create 0 below the 2-2 position. So for that, I can decide raw operations very easily. R3 replaced by R3 plus R2. And R4 replaced by R4 plus 2R2. So in the next form of the Euclidean matrix, in the next form of the Euclidean matrix, I will apply these two raw operations on the above form of the Euclidean matrix. So if I apply this, then the first row will remain unchanged. So I write 1 1 2 0 as the first row. The second row will also remain unchanged. So I write 0 1 2 1. Now I calculate the third row. Third row is R3 plus R2. So I sum third and second row. So I will have 4 and 3. 0 0 4 3 in the third row. For the fourth row, I need to apply R4 plus 2 R2 operation. So I apply R4 plus 2 R2 operation. So here I will have 0. R4 plus 2 R2. So here also I will have 0. R4 plus 2 R2. So I will have 8 here. R4 plus 2 R2. So I will have 6 here. So this is the next form of the Euclidean matrix. Now I concentrate on the 3-3 position, the main diagonal position. I have created 0 below the 1-1 position. I have created 0s below the 2-2 position. Now I have entries below the 3-3 position. So I will try to create 0 below this 3-3 position. So for that, I can apply R4 minus 2R3 operation. So R4 minus 2R3 operation will create a 0 below this 3-3 position. So when I will apply this operation, you will find that the Euclidean matrix will convert into this matrix. First row will be 1 1 2 0. Second row will be 0 1 2 1, and third row will be 0 0 4 3, and fourth row will be a 0 row. So now I observe that the matrix has converted into an upper triangular form, and this form is also an SLM form, because there is no two rows which are constant multiple of each other or which are equal. So I have converted the Euclidean matrix into the SLM form. Now I again decide the rank of the Euclidean matrix. So the rank of the Euclidean matrix will be equal to 3, because there are 3 non-zero rows in this Euclidean matrix, and I decide the rank of the coefficient matrix. So to decide the rank of the coefficient matrix, I ignore the last column. So the rank of the coefficient matrix is also 3. So the rank of the Euclidean matrix, AD is equal to rank of the coefficient matrix. Therefore the system will be consistent and will have a solution, and the common number is 3 here, and this 3 is equal to number of unknowns of the system, because the given system has 3 unknowns. So the rank of the Euclidean matrix is equal to rank of the coefficient matrix. Therefore the system will be consistent, and this common number 3 is equal to the number of unknown. Therefore the system will have a unique solution. Now to find that unique solution, what I will need to do, I will need to convert this last SLM form into a set of linear equations. So I convert this SLM form into the system of equations. So I get x plus y plus 2z equal to 0, and y plus 2z equal to 1, and 4z equal to 3. So I get only 3 equations. Now you can observe that this reduced system of equations will have solution equal to the solutions of the given system of linear equations. which has four equations. So instead of solving this system of linear equation, I will solve this system of linear equation, because it will reduce our computational efforts. So when you will solve this system of linear equation, then you will find that z is equal to 3/4, and if you will put z equal to 3/4 here in the second equation, then you will get y plus 3/2 equal to 1. So your y will be equal to -2, and when you will put y equal to -2 and z equal to 3/4, so you will get x -2 plus 3/2. So you will get x equal to 1. So this is the solution of the given system of linear equation. So in this way, by applying the method of rank, we can solve a system of linear equation having any number of equations and any which are not equal to the number of unknowns also. Whereas using Cramer's rule and matrix inversion method, we can solve the system of equations having number of unknowns and number of equations equal. So this is the advantage of this method of rank. In the next lecture, I will discuss how to solve the system of homogeneous linear equation, and I will also discuss few problems on non-homogeneous equations involving some unknown constant. So in the system, if in the system of equations we have some unknown constant here as a coefficient, and then how to find the values of those constant for the unique solution case and for the no solution case and other cases. So that part we will discuss in the next lecture.